Hey everyone, it's me, Jurgel B. Thank you guys for coming back to my channel. And for today's video, I will be showing you guys how to get this look on my face. So if you guys wanna see how I did this look, come back. Keep on watching. I look so weird because I just have eyebrows on. I did my face. Primer is already done. So let's proceed to the face. Something's itchy. I'm mixing two drinks, coconut juice and coffee. I can't decide which one I should drink, but I definitely need more coffee. Okay, today I'm going to use the Urban Decay Naked Skin and Done. Oh, Naked Skin One and Done. Concealer. I'm still using this one because I love this concealer. Hey Honey Trick and Treat. Trick and Treat. Concealer. I'm going to use the Too Faced Burn. I'm going to use the Too Faced Born This Way setting powder. Set the concealer. Use the Becca Sunlit Bronzer in Bali Sands. I like this bronzer, especially during summer, because it has shimmers. So I'm not going to contour today. I'm just gonna bronze, and I'm using this really, really pretty brush by Real Techniques 103. Bring it down to your neck so it looks blended. I'm gonna stop there. I have with my bronzer, and I'm gonna work with my eyes now. I'm gonna be using the Modern Renaissance palette by ABH. This is going to be my third look using this palette. Easy and simple, and I need something to set my eyes. Alright, so I'm just gonna use this setting powder because I don't have any bone color from that palette to set that concealer that we put in there earlier to prime our lid. So for today's look, I'm actually just going to use one color in the inner eyelids, and it's going to be the Bon Fresco, if that's how you say it. Bon Fresco or Boon Fresco. Either way, that's what we are going for. We're gonna use that color right there. It's the e.l.f. Flawless Concealer Brush, but I've been loving this brush for my eyeshadows. And we're gonna start right out here and out outer corner of your eye. I usually do. I like the color here to be a little bit darker. I'm just gonna go for small circles and just gonna bring it in. I like to go, the reason why I like bringing that in when you have less product. But it just gives you this really blown out look, which I like. Just gonna swipe like this. Is that swipe or sweep? Sweep. Sweep towards here. Up. So I'm just gonna keep blending until I'm satisfied with my blending. Just grab any flat brush that you guys have and then just dip into that same color, the Bone Fresco or Bon Fresco. I don't know how to say that. And then for this one, we're just going to tap that into all over our lid. And just putting that in all over our lid. Now it's in, it's using the same brush. I'm just gonna drag that in the lower lash line. That word drag is so bad for the skin, but I'm just using the same brush to put that same color and connecting it in the lower lash line. What I've been into recently is smoking the lower lash line. I don't know why, but I've just been more focused on my lower lash line. I love it. Okay, so I'm gonna go for this kind of brush right here. This is the Luxie 215. It's a small angled brush and I'm gonna dip into Love Letter in the palette and I'm going to put that in my outer corner in the lower lash line outer corner. A pencil brush like this and we're gonna dip into the same color, Love Letter. And we're just gonna smoke it out. And bring it lower. All right, so our goal is to look like we have a pink eye for the day. Yes. Then just cleaning that brush because I'm gonna be using the same brush and then I'm gonna go back to Bon Fresco, the same color that we have all over our upper lid, and we're just going to put that here. But not close all the way, just a little bit lower. I put it right there. And bring it underneath that too, underneath the red. I'm gonna go back and use the same angled brush that I used with the Love Letter earlier, but make sure you clean it first. I'm too lazy to find another angled brush. I mean, they're all in this stack right here. I'm just too lazy to grab it. I know. I shouldn't be making videos if I'm lazy, but hey. We all have those days, okay? So using the same brush, the same angled brush, I'm gonna dip into Cypress Umber. Cypress Umber is the darkest color that they have in the palette and I'm gonna dip into that color and I'm going to line my upper lash line with that color. And I'm gonna be dragging that out a little bit. Like so. And I'm gonna bring it in all the way. And I'm using the Stay Put Waterproof Eyeliner by Milani. This is actually dark brown. This Hooked on Espresso. That's what it says. I know it's not black. It's like chocolate dark brown. Tight lining makes your eyelashes look thicker. I'm not going to put it in the waterline. I'm going to put it outside the waterline. And then I'm gonna grab a pencil brush and just blend that in so it doesn't look too harsh. Now I'm gonna go back to the palette and grab more Love Letter. because that eyeliner actually sort of like got rid of the letter, love letter color that I have in there. So I'm just gonna dip into that and then put it back some more, and then just bringing it lower. Primavera, that's the gold color in the eyeshadow palette, and I am going to put that in the inner corner all the way down to the inner part of our lower lash line. This is a NYX Wonder Pencil. This is in light. That's the shade. It's actually a neutral color. It's not white, but it's neutral or cream color. And we're just gonna put that in the waterline, lower lash line. Curl them lashes and put some mascara on. Lashes, I'm gonna be using the Monsieur Big lashes from Lancome. I really don't like this. I have to go out and buy me another mascara because I don't like this. But this is actually the only one I have, because I had to throw away my L'Oreal Paradise lashes mascara, I mean, because it was too dry. That is the only downside of that mascara. It gets too dry really quick. Since we've already done bronzing our face, we're gonna move on to blush. And for today, oh my gosh, I know I've been using the same blush over and over again, but I just been loving this blush palette right here. It's really actually B. I've been saying Bay for so long, and I just realized it that it's actually B. And lately, I've been putting my brushes, my blush. See that? Oh my gosh, pigmented. And like I was saying, lately I've been putting my blushes really high up on my cheek right here. Okay, we need another brush to blend that in. My babies were just recently washed, and so that's why they look so pretty and brand new, because I just washed them. Since this is my everyday look, I really don't want to be popping. So we're just gonna go for, I'm gonna use the Essence Pure Nude Highlighter. It's one of my favorite highlighters. And this is very, very subtle highlight. This just makes you, or this just gives you that glow from within type of highlight. Where center of your forehead. Alright, I am going to use a Lumiere 2 for my lips because it also has that mauve-y look. Like I said, I've been going for the monotone type of look recently. But I'm not going to go for a full-on lip color with this one. You'll see what I mean in a little bit. So I've just been doing that where I put the lipstick in the bottom of my lip in the middle, and then, you know, I make sure that the color of the lipstick goes up to my lips too. I just put my lips together like this, and then I use my finger to blend it in. Strongest color is actually in the middle of your lip. So when that one's done, when you're done blending it, what I usually do is put in a bright color in the middle, and this is the Buxom Pump Line Lip Liner. It's actually a lip liner, but I'm gonna put that here in the middle right here. I'll blend it in with your finger again and do the same thing. Just gonna put it right in the bottom. Right there. And I'll blend it in. I'm going to grab my concealer brush, the one that I use for blending, and I'm going to grab loose powder, and I'm going to put that around the outside perimeter of my lips to give you more of that radiant effect again. We're done. That was quick. All right, and then we're gonna set this face. The content of this bottle is the Mario Badescu facial mist, the one with lavender, but the bottle I got from Daiso. Yes, love it. And there you go, we are done. Thank you so much for watching and coming back to my channel. I hope you guys enjoy that tutorial. Very, very easy and quick tutorial, I hope. And before I let you guys go, I'd like to say happy Mother's Day to all the moms out there. And just remember that in the eyes of your children, you are the best mom in the world. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.